everybody likes to laugh, but where do the best jokes come from? A North Texas comedian with loads of experience is sharing what he knows about the process of writing comedy.
He's offering workshops to those who want to find out how funny they really are. Dan Godwin has a look in tonight's Fox Forward.
Any age, a spanking is effective. As a matter of fact, I don't think police should ticket anymore. They should just spank bad drivers on the freeway. You'd slow down, wouldn't you? You're going down the freeway, someone's on the shoulder getting a whipping. You drive by, oh my God. Ooh. Man, move your hands, he's gonna hit harder. Hey, let's go back around and look one more time. What do you say?
Dean Lewis has spent much of his life finding out what it takes to amuse a room full of strangers. Dean's been a stand-up comic for the past 25 years. We've heard him on morning radio, and these days he's also been sharing his talents with corporate America at various gatherings. Thanks for coming in.
Nice to be here, Dan. So thankful.
And another thing you're doing these days, offering these one-day workshops
Yes.
focused on joke writing or sketch and comedy writing. Well, what you're trying to do is teach other people how to be funny. Can
yeah.
that be done?
It can be done. That's a big thing is people think, well, you're not born funny or you're not a funny person. That doesn't matter. If you're in the writer's room, you can be very depressed, very sad, eating donuts, making $4,000 a week. It doesn't matter. So yeah, there's a structure, there's a technique, and a lot of people really want to do that.
Are there certain principles you try to get across to the students?
Yes, absolutely. So the biggest thing, if I had to teach one in one sentence, everything you need to know about comedy, it's not that simple, of course, but it's the idea of incongruity. Just taking two things that don't match up and finding a way of connecting them. So one of the things we do in the joke writing workshop is we find news stories, topical news stories, and we try and write, I teach people how to write jokes from that. And then there's a technique for finding those associations and putting them together. So, and here's another thing, you asked earlier, what's another thing I could teach you? The other thing is just remember this, it's about quantity, it's not about quality. And I know that sounds bad, but you know, when Jay Leno used to have The Tonight Show, he had 20 writers who would write 100 jokes a day. So he had about 2,000 jokes daily that he would pick the best 35 out of. The reason they write 100 is that the average is one good joke out of 10. So you have to write 100 to get the 10 good ones. So there is a demand for people who can write a lot of material, and that's what these workshops show you.
And they last 6 hours, the workshop. Obviously, they include remarks from you.
Yes.
But on that very day, the students, they sit down, they pull out the paper, and they start to write.
Yeah. You start off, within the first 10 minutes, I have a writing exercise you do, and then the rest of the day, we keep going back to that and punching it up, finding the jokes in that, because that's part of my process is, how do you take something that's very unfunny and then find the comedy in it?
And you're saying there are opportunities out there?
Yeah. You know, and right now what's really interesting is that there's so many talk shows. I mean, look at them. They're just during the day, during the night, and they're always looking for writers. And they always have a real high turnover rate. Most writers last 2 years. And by that time, they're burnt out, or they're going to go and their sitcom got sold, or they're working on a movie or whatever. So there's a high turnover rate, and there's a true opportunity to submit your writer's packet with what I teach you. And you could very conceivably get a call from, you know, Fox 4, and they're like, hey, we're doing a new show starring the Dan Godwin show.
And boy, does he need writers. Another thing you're up to these days, the Oddcast podcast, a weekly lifestyle show with
yes.
lots of different features and lots of jokes. So best of luck with that. Thank you for coming in. Thank you for the chat. For more information about Dean's comedy workshops as well as the Oddcast podcast, we've got links at our website. Just go to fox4news.com.